Jeremy, Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. The Raging Cajuns have shown few signs of weakness lately. They are exuding confidence in everything they do. Bring together a few W's, that's exactly what happens. We'll see if they can keep it up.
We've done all we can do here. Time to tee it up. Let's send it out to Brad and Kirk for the call. David and I will be with you at halftime. Coca-Cola taste at zero calories. Enjoy everything. Raging Cajuns, and talking with them this week, Kirk, it's just interesting their perspective on this kid, how good he is, and how much they can lean on him.
Yeah, you and I had a chance to visit with not only the coaches, but the player himself, and I got a real good vibe walking out of those meetings and thinking that he's going to have a huge game. The coaches seem confident in being able to get him the football in different areas of the field. This kid has a look in his eye that I haven't seen in a long time. He just wants to have a chance to have an impact on the game and on the outcome. He's shocked to slow him down.
There he goes! He's at midfield. Inside the 30 for the 10. And he's all the way in for the touchdown. The
Raging Cajuns always have guys that are near the top statistically, and that's no exception today. We're really looking forward to watching this kid play.
And he hits the PAT.
Set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep. And he got all of this one. Great kick. He's to the 20. And down he goes. The 21-yard line.
The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game.
From their own 26-yard line. Second down.
Go, four!
Throws to the tight end, and that ball's incomplete.
The tight end is a big guy, and you're not doing him any favors if you're putting the ball at his feet like that.
Man, as an offensive lineman, this is the worst thing that you want to see, is your quarterback not only getting sacked, but getting hit like that. Those linemen better pick that quarterback up and start doing a better job of taking care of him.
Calhoun to punt. Oh, excellent punt.
Down at the 49-yard line.
They
They ran the ball very well on their last drive, and it resulted in six.
Louisiana Lafayette is up a score. So close to breaking it.
He aired that one out a long, long way. It takes tremendous touch to make that completion.
Big play there, and now they're looking at first and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
They're at the three. Second down. They're packed in tight on the line. Touchdown, Ragin' Cajuns. And he adds the extra point. A four-play, 51-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points. So our score, 14-0. They line up to kick this one away.
Sends it sailing downfield. He's to the 20.
He's hit and got away. He's tackled at the 19-yard line. The defense shut them down on their last drive, forcing a quick punt.
They've been beaten soundly on both sides of the ball, and we haven't even gotten to the second quarter.
He wants it all, going long. And he hits him hard at the 42-yard line.
This second, they're going to tighten it up, taking a slow down this drive.
And the big pickup through the air has made it first and 10. He lets it fly.
The junior makes the catch.
And he's tackled at the back of 13.
What a great play.
This is the timing that we talked about in the pregame that they must have in order to be successful for the passing game.
That time the quarterback threw it to a spot, and his receiver was there to make a nice grab.
It's first and 10.
Ball on the 13.
Run play and he'll lose yards. The lineman had a big push there to get in the backfield and bring him down.
And once he gets moving, there's no stopping him. This guy is so big and strong that he's almost impossible to block with one guy.
Bring him down at the 16.
Loss of 2 yards on the play. That'll make it 13.
It's third down and 13 to go. Ball on the 16-yard line.
Sometimes all you need to do is throw off the defender's timing just a little bit at the start of the play.
Thank you.
poll. And for Iowa, they now have 9 wins, a very solid year.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Nice kick, plenty of distance. He's to the 20, and he's taken down at the 23-yard line.
Raging Cajuns having their way on offense so far in this football game.
Just a nice rhythm to what they're trying to do. It's a balanced attack, running and throwing, and right now this defense just can't stop them.
The offense ready for the first play of this drive. They move the ball extremely well on their last possession on their way to the end zone.
This quarterback right now is in a rhythm, and a lot of that has to do with his preparation. You can see right now with the reads that he's being able to make, getting the football out of his hands, that he's feeling very, very confident in his ability to throw the football against his defense.
Louisiana Lafayette
is up by a touchdown. Down 10 yards to go. Ball on the 34-yard line.
So it's another third down upcoming here. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with 5 wideouts. Tries to thread the needle and it's not going to work. And now he's got room to run.
First and 10. Ball on their own 43. Louisiana Lafayette up 7 points.
Touchdown,
Tackle made at the 25.
First down.
Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here.
And they make the stop at the 9.
Good job here by the receiver to look the ball in and ensure he had possession. That's the right way to catch a pass.
87's getting the ball. 87's getting the ball.
Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
That brings him 7 yards.
Here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
It's third and goal from the 1, and they're trying to make this a 2-possession ball game. Rolls quickly into the end zone, caught for the touchdown.
He makes the get set to get.
They need about 3 yards to get the first down.
Spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a 5-wide outlook.
Everybody enthusiastic. You can see the momentum that this offense is gaining. The coaches and the players on the sideline fired up. And he set it down.
This close, you can't afford to waste possessions. 7.
Quick strike to the receiver. And he's tackled 25 yard line. The middle.
That's a D of 10 on the play.
First down. Two down.
I love to see a confident quarterback, but you don't want to just go back there and put blind faith into your throws. You need a little bit more time to evaluate the coverage before you release the football.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 35-yard line.
They dropped him well short of the line of scrimmage.
Pierce is the deep man waiting the return.
Tackle made at the 49.
With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads.
Might be neck and neck the whole way. They'll line up with five wide receivers. Wants to go long and does. Missed him.
That makes it second and 10.
From their own 49-yard line, it's second down.
Makes the catch and the defense is all over him. They bring him down for a loss.
Well, the defense has done their job and made a nice stand. Now let's see if the special teams can come up with something here as well.
Doesn't want to let the punt returner have a chance here. He just wants to change field position. Very high punt converge. Better watch out. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Ragin' Cajun's game plan is just what we've been seeing through a couple of quarters now. Give this guy the football and let him ram it down the defense's throat and just keep giving it to him until he gets tired or the defense gets tired.
Well, the offensive line, I also think, deserves a lot of credit. You know, the back is the star. He's been getting most of the yards and most of the attention. But he's not doing it alone. The offensive line's paving the way and opening this thing up, and the running back's taking advantage of it. They've had a great first half.
For Osborne, it seems like he spent the whole season in the other team's backfield.
This guy's beating the man across from him. Double teams, triple teams, chip blocks, help from the backfield, you name it. Nothing's been able to slow this guy down.
Defense looking for another sack in this second down and long situation. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. And he's hit before he can go anywhere.
They come out in a five wide set.
He's scrambling. They'll bring him down at the 33. Louisiana Lafayette is up a score. At the 43-yard line.
That's good for gaining 10 yards.
That'll make it second and inches.
will spread the field with five wide. Stays in bounds. He made a nice catch.
That makes it first and 10.
Goes right around the 32-yard line.
That's a gain of 9 on the play. That brings in second and 1.
47 miles. 5 wide.
Great job by the defense of getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
And they'll look to convert here on another third down.
And he's immediately tackled.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards.
Louisiana Lafayette is up by a touchdown.
Just throws this one away. They've been 2 for 2 on third downs of this drive, and they'll try to convert again here. Keep it on the ground with a tailback. Makes it after maybe the 20-yard line.
That was some sure tape to make sure he didn't get on the first down.
Louisiana Lafayette can make this a two-possession game with his field goal. He gets it up, and he got it.
They line up to kick this one away. He's to the 20. Tackle at the 24-yard line.
So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field.
So an empty backfield with 5 wide receivers.
He airs it out.
Oh, he had a shot at the pin.
I'm not sure the quarterback saw him when he was getting ready to pass because he stuck his paw right in the passing lane.
On their own 24-yard line. Second down.
There's a strike complete. Steps out of bounds.
About the 37-yard line.
Now, if you do send this offense the right way, it's almost like you have an extra wide receiver. He's that good.
He's immediately tackled behind the line.
Hamilton doing the tackle at the 36-yard line. That'll bring up second and 11.
Check 59. Mike is 59. Mike is 59. Go off the ball. Go off. Hey, go.
Throws it out and it falls incomplete.
Your boy says he intended to see him. That makes it 7-11.
From their own 26-yard line. Third down.
And two, three, 15.
Sails it low. And he's got it. Touchdown. Huge play. And for Daly, he takes his receiving yardage total to 100.
It's for this reason that he is the most dynamic player on this field today. He can run the ball through you or around you. And on top of that, he's a magnificent weapon in passing game.
There's still a lot of ball game to play, fellas. And he adds the extra point. Calhoun looks ready to kick this one off. Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchdown.
Well, Herbie, nothing else. We're keeping Reese Davis busy because the updates are coming from our game.
Yeah, and the good thing about so many updates is Pollock doesn't have any room to talk because all it is Reese and these highlights.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. With so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Louisiana Lafayette is up by three. Under heavy pressure, throws it to the outside. Raging Cajuns taking their first time out of the half. From their own 47-yard line, it's first down. He makes it out to maybe the 49-yard line. Harris picks up 2 yards with a carry. Raging Cajuns are going to call their second timeout. Incomplete pass. He threw that to a guy who was well covered and it almost got intercepted.
Yeah, he's very lucky. That ball was only tipped.
Third down, they need to get inside the 43. Crosses out her tailback on the screen, and they make the stop at the 46-yard line. Both defensive coordinators will be going back to the drawing board in the locker room at halftime. 24-21, Raging Cajuns.
We played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollock and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. Both offenses roll.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. Excellent kick. He's tackled at the 16. And for Daly, he's been causing headaches for this secondary all night long.
Well, not only is he having a great game, but he's also just seems to be having fun out there. I think the entire offense, for that matter, the entire team, seems to be responding to his infectious attitude.
His yards per catch average is in another stratosphere. Gains his way to the 30-yard line. their own 30-yard line. First down. Gets out to about the 31. Complete, brought down, nothing doing.
Gain of 2 yards. That'll bring up third and eight.
Third and eight. Ball in the 33. They'll line up with five wide receivers.
Go four, yellow three. Hey, kill, kill, kill. Flare. Kill, kill.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 37. Nothing this time around.
Called a loss of 2 yards on the play. That'll bring up second and 12.
Here's the eighth play of the series.
That's three. Pass.
Check 59.
Back five. Back
five. He's taken down at the 7 yard line. And here's another third down. The PAT. Let's go to the studio for this Reese Davis update.
As we check in on the Sun Belt Conference, this league is known for its offense, but sometimes defense carries the day. And for Arkansas State, they've dropped two straight.
Looks like they're ready for the game. The Raging Cajuns lose one of their key players. That injury earlier, still in the locker room. We don't know the severity, but unlikely that we'll play any more football this afternoon. He just drills this one. He's taken down at the 26. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Dumps it complete to the halfback over the middle. Brought down around. now the 32-yard line.
Recognize that the defense made a great play. They read it from the get-go.
Pierce is back deep to return. He's to the 40. Tackle made at the 48-yard line. Raging Cajun's plan was to run the ball, and they are doing it as well as we've seen it.
Yeah, they're running the football. These backs seem to be hitting the holes just at the right time. And how about the offensive line? Just opening up some nice holes. Just doing what this offense needs to do to be successful. It's early in this game, so the defense can still have an opportunity to make some adjustments. But if things don't turn around in a hurry, it's really going to start to affect the psyche of our defensive line.
Got his receiver, dropped it, incomplete.
That makes it second and 10.
From their own 48-yard line, second down. He makes it out to midfield.
Gain of two on the play. That'll bring up third and eight.
See if the momentum from that defensive stand carries over to their offense.
Fourth down.
Calhoun is the punter. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. They'll bring him down at the 28.
Gain of eight on the play. That makes it second and two.
He's at midfield. And he's brought down
at the 39.
First down.
Up, looks long enough, and he just drilled it from long range. Louisiana Lafayette lines up for the kickoff. He sends this one deep. He's to the 10, he's to the 20, got the corner. And he's taken down at the 30. We'll be right back. They're set to go for another round.
Check 59. Mike is 59.
They'll spread the field with five wide. Almost intercepted.
Daily intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and 10.
From their own 30-yard line. Second down. Nice run up the middle.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards. That'll bring up third and 6.
On the play. That's going to bring up fourth down.
Great hold by the defense. They were expecting the pass play, and they defended it very well.
Calhoun is waiting for the snap. He got hit hard. Not a bad return. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. And he throws it away. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
From their own 38-yard line, it's second down. Two.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the kick.
Can they pull off the upset? Well, we're going to find out as we head into the fourth quarter. 28-27, Tiger. Back in this very pivotal fourth quarter. He's out of bounds at the 49-yard line. Maxwell picks him up about 3 yards with a catch. He's down.
Call the game 6 yards.
They're not quite in field goal range here. This is a really important play on this drive. And down he goes at the 30-yard line.
Call the game 18 yards. First down.
Trying to get a head start there.
Maybe he got the cadence wrong coming out of the huddle. The coaches have a low threshold for mistakes like that.
So we'll have first and 15 after the penalty.
The smart quarterbacks and offensive linemen have a really unique relationship. A quarterback should take care of his offensive linemen. But after that play and that hit, you really got to be wondering what kind of relationship this quarterback and his offensive linemen have after that.
And this is the eighth play of the drive. Five wide.
with room to work.
He's knocked out of bounds.
Right around the 36-yard line.
I like that they're completing these underneath routes, because pretty soon the defense is going to start to cheat up. That's when the quarterback will have his chance to go over the top for the big play.
They're ready to get off the field, and now they've just handed the offense a whole new set of downs.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 14-yard line. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. So he calls his own number and gets about 6 yards.
That'll bring up second and 2.
Well, a familiar situation for the offense as they try to convert another third down. They've converted three already. Pass incomplete. He'll let that pass get away from him.
I think he's a little bit anxious. He actually looked a little bit too juiced that time, but he'll get the next one.
Kicks away, and it's puts the uprights. Let's check in with Reese Davis in the studio.
The Wildcats were ranked number 23. A tough, solid performance, but still a loss. Will they be able to stay in the poll? And for Oklahoma, their hot streak continues.
Nice kick, plenty of distance.
To the corner, and he's tackled to the 42-yard line.
This is a pretty crucial series right here. With things being so tight, your best players have to step it up on both sides of the ball. Ball on the 46. Tackle made on the 46-yard line.
That'll bring up second and three.
Right and left, right and left. Four down, check 59. Mike is
red to the right.
From the 24-yard line, first down.
I got number 18.
Gets out to about the 21.
That'll make it second and 7.
First and goal from the 4, looking for Pater. And he tackles him hard at the 3.
Gain of 2 yards. That brings him second and goal.
Just under 3 to go in regulation. He's in!
in. Touchdown. And they take the lead.
A 7-play, 67-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result.
Boy, this offense right now is just being physical, really controlling the line of scrimmage, and it's opening up some nice big lanes for the running back.
They line up to kick this one away. Excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Raging Cajuns were really mistaken if they looked at this game as a gimmick.
Well, they've been in a dogfight the entire ball game. Let's see what they can do with this final drive. They still have time here to be able to pull out and try to get a win.
Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. Throws incomplete. They got a hand on it. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 25. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun. Five wide receivers. He's in trouble. Quick out to his receiver. And he's taken down right around the 48-yard line. They come out in a five wide set. Around the 48-yard line.
That makes it 7-6.
Throws complete. He's got room to work. And he's tackled around the 40-yard line. A little more than 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. Couldn't hang on here in the fourth quarter. From the 40-yard line, it's second down. Harris, the guy. He's got him out in the backfield. Quick strike to the receiver. Locked down around the 21-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
You don't really gain anything by kicking the extra point here, so they'll go for two and try to go up by three. Looks to him again, complete. They got it. Louisiana Lafayette to kick this one off. From his own goal line. He's to the 20. Tackle, the 26-yard line. The Tigers battled all game long, but it's not looking so good right now.
Well, but remember, they're still within striking distance here. If they can put together a drive, they got a shot to win this game.
Late in the fourth quarter in a one-possession game, and poise is what it's all about here. Who's going to have it and who won't? They'll line up with five wide receivers.
I think it was a great play call. It was very well executed. Any coach would be happy with that kind of outcome on a
third second down play.
Short yardage situation here. Second down and one. Under a minute left in the game. Wants it all. Going deep. It's intercepted, and that should do it. He's at the 20. That's a great tackle.
At the 10.
He steps up and makes a big turnover.
Yeah, he just made a huge play right there. He knew what was coming all along.
Preparation has come to fruition.
How nice is it for a coaching staff to see a plan come together? They had an outstanding plan throughout the game, but at the biggest moment, they found a way to get their go-to guy the football the most, and he was able to deliver.
And with time winding down, they probably won't let this return man field the ball. They'll bring him down at the 33. This is what you dream about, situations like this. You've got the football, you're behind, but if you take the lead, it could mean a win. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. Wants to go long and done. And rebound at the 25-yard line. Defensive coordinator anticipating this final line set, and he comes in with his dime package. They cannot afford to take sacks at this point in this ball game.
No, they cannot. This is do or die time.
Let's go, let's bring it. Let's go, let's bring it. Let's bring it.
Spikes the ball. Trailing here in the fourth quarter, a vital third down and very long. And it all comes down to this one last chance to throw one up and see if somebody can bring it down and win the game. That's just a huge stop right there here late in the fourth quarter in a game this tight. That might be one we look back on later and say that won the ball game. The Raging Cajuns know that they have to enjoy this guy while they've got him, because somewhere down the line he's going to be at the next level.
Well, that'll definitely be in his future, but for now he needs to sit back and just enjoy this performance. And really, the play caller, the quarterback, the offensive line, the receivers, the entire group as just a whole should feel good about their performance.
That brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.